Hello? Hello? Is this thing on? Hello? Can you hear me? Hello? Is everything working?
Yeah.
Can you see me, honey?
Yeah.
Can you see me? Is it
working? Alright, it's working. Hi, everybody. Peter's gone. Does anyone? No. Welcome to A Couple of Quackers. We are joined today with James and Cleo. We're having some issues with coughing, but you know.
Every time you cough, it's exactly the same.
Don't fake it, sounding cough.
I mean, it's a cough nonetheless.
This is a great start.
Always a good start. If you start with coughing, you know it's a real party.
You guys need a theme song.
We do need a theme song. We have an outro. We have kind of an intro. I mean, I'm sure we can,
just remix some coughing.
Remix coughing?
Yeah.
Alright, we're joined today with James and Cleo. Hi, everybody. It's James and Cleo.
Hi.
Cough. That's how you started this episode.
I'm Peter.
I'm Ned.
Okay. We're a couple of quackers. We're gonna be doing. Are you okay?
No, are you done?
I regret. Ugh.
It's just an audio track she plays every time she wants attention.
Yeah.
Yeah, she actually just has her phone. She has her phone on our phone as we like. For those who can't see us, she's currently putting her phone onto the phone and hitting a soundboard. Application.
Oh, sorry, that was mine.
That was your schoolboy Jew.
Schoolboy Jew.
Oh,
soundtrack.
Jew.
Do.
Okay. Anyway.
Collard Greens. Anyone?
Do.
The only song.
The album or the song?
Both.
Okay.
Well,
still
the only one people know.
True. Mad Dog Records is known for their tutus.
Do. Is it like that scream? What's the one? The Star Wars...
The Wilhelm Scream. Yeah.
Wilhelm Scream. All right. I just want to bring this up because I brought this up to Peter and this blew his mind because I thought of it because I guess, you know, I'm in the arts and shit. I don't know. But someone who made that had to copyright that and then made money every single time that was played in a movie. So whenever that's played in a someone's making
50s.
Millions. Someone's making so much money. And I mean, every 50 years your copyright expires. So theoretically, he could have lost it. However,
or he did, like.
But he could have renewed it. That's the thing. Like he could have. I'm pretty sure.
What's so special about that scream that they use it so much?
It's a staple.
It's
Spielberg has a thing for it, and George Lucas a thing for it because it was in Star Wars. It was in any it's in all the movies. Yeah.
They made it famous. It's used in every movie now. The guy.
But the thing is, I guess, like we don't know. We don't know that he. It was the movie in the 50s.
It was.
Do you want to know a fun story about George Lucas?
Yes.
Yeah.
All right.
Always.
So when they were deciding.
Oh, you told me this.
Yeah. when they were deciding what was going to be done for like what was going to be CGI, what was going to be prop scene, he'd written everything out on this big like blackboard in front of him, and he goes up and he's got two highlighters in his hand, and one's for props, one's for CGI. And he's sitting there, and like the teams are like biting their nails, they're like separated on two sides, and he goes up and he takes a cap off full of the highlighters, and he just one right after the other goes after them, no thought process whatsoever. And then that led to Jar Jar Binks, like the suit for Jar Jar Binks, them hiring a guy to play him and paying like $10 million for his fucking suit for Jar Jar Binks. And the CGI people made it for like $10,000, and everybody unanimously was like, hey, this is way fucking better. And George Lucas was like, oh, this is better, let's just use this. But they already, the Jar Jar Binks actor signed a contract. Yeah, so they wasted a ton of money, and he signed a contract. So they paid him to stand in the spots where Jar Jar Binks would be when they were blocking the scenes and stuff.
Oh my god. Because they wanted to use him for something.
Yeah.
Okay, I have another
paying
one.
Paying you no matter
what. So they actually saved, like, a ton of money on CGI and special effects.
Anyone?
No, because as they were casting and, like, finding makeup people for Jabba the Hutt, George Lucas actually decided he'd just play him himself. and That's the legend.
Like, we'll just fire the actor right now.
No makeup.
No makeup, no nothing. It's just Jabba the Hutt just looks like George Lucas.
It's
so
just cameo scenes.
No.
Really? What's the deal?
First off, no one knows who the actor was.
What?
No one knows. So,
For the Wilhelm scream, we're back
to the
prisoner's.
The actual voice of the Wilhelm scream remains a mystery, but many believe it to be the voice of Sheb Woolley, but he didn't get royalties for it. His wife, he's dead.
Wow.
And he's also most famous for his song, The Purple Peter Eater. Purple People. Purple People Eater.
That's a pretty famous song, though. I'm pretty sure I remember this song. I'm just...
Your heart is so hard right now.
Yeah, I don't know what's up with that.
Let's not drink.
I mean, I'm gonna keep doing that, but that's just me.
Yeah, I think James Bay also has to lay off the Coca-Cola. If I'm quitting it, you're quitting it.
Okay. Where were we?
Cool.
We explained the Coke addiction last episode,
yeah.
So you understand.
Have we explained?
He's still doing it. Everyone give a quick little...
Yay!
To Peter for quitting Coke.
Yeah, I've only scratched beneath my skin a few times.
Just a few.
I've
as long as you don't draw blood too much.
Bled into my mattress a few times. Those look like...
Done.
Super done. I got okay. Just a reference again, because this is a podcast and therefore an audio thingy. Although I think we should someday do a video podcast, like a video,
one day,
like a
do
vlog.
A,
but
do
I don't want
a VOD.
A VOD.
A video podcast.
A podcast. But yeah, just reference. He's made steaks on the grill, and he's kind of excited.
Kind of excited.
So this is another Q&A, I guess, for now. We'll do some questions that you guys asked us. It seems to be like a rerun of like three people ask like weird questions. But we'll do some questions and then we'll talk. We'll do some stories. We'll do some stories too. You guys want to start with questions or stories?
Questions.
All right, cool. We'll go with an easy first one, and I'll shout so that Nat can hear me, but he's getting closer, so I might not have to shout by that time. Yeah, okay. Nat. Five Alive or Sunny D?
Five Alive.
And it means Sunny D the juice, not Sunny Dick.
I know.
Because we already know that answer.
What? You don't mean
Sunny
Dick
with
in the
with
sun?
Vowel.
I'm so disappointed.
I.e.
Five Alive all the way.
I also vote Five Alive.
Really?
I'm just
no. Yeah, definitely Five Alive.
I like Sunny D more. I find Five Alive too tangy. I find it like it's super, super.
I find Sunny D.
Yeah,
too
no,
sweet.
I heard what you said. I just disagree.
Okay. I just find Sunny D is the closest thing to like edible plastic you can get.
Yeah.
So it's not my thing.
One time though, I did drink Sunny D through a Twizzler.
Oh,
so God. I don't know. I'm kind of down to peg.
Processed cheese.
Oh.
Is probably closer to plastic. I don't know. Actually eating
cheese
plastic.
Cheese Whiz. Are marshmallows like a chemical away from being plastic?
Petroleum.
Or like garbage bags or something like that?
Gas.
No doubt.
Alright.
They're a very close petroleum based product. Yeah.
Even better.
Yummy.
Delicious.
That's why marshmallows.
Isn't that right?
That's why marshmallows light fire so easy. You put it like right in the fire and then it becomes a fucking blowtorch. That's why. That's crazy.
No, I totally remember that.
I'm not very good at making wheeze.
My favorite marshmallows were the black ones.
Mm-hmm.
Of course.
Yeah, I just torch them.
Yeah, that's what my dad did. He just lights on fire.
Fuck waiting for it to toast.
Golden
to, like,
brown, man.
Yeah.
Golden brown.
No.
Golden brown was like
stuck
the
it
first
in the flame.
One. Every other one was black.
Honestly, it came to a point. I was a fat kid. I'm not afraid to admit it. I was bullied by my little brother for a long time.
So long.
I just ate like whole marshmallows. I'd put marshmallows, chocolate, and graham crackers, and I wouldn't do the bonfire shit. I'd just like put it in my mouth. They were great. I did like one piece at a time. I didn't know what s'mores really were at the time. I was like, oh, cool, we put them all together. Oh.
You
know,
I think it's a cheap out, those celebration cookies that say they're for s'mores, because in my opinion, they do not have enough chocolate to warrant being actual good s'mores.
Where is this?
They're like graham crackers.
Or they're
with
also
the
called
chocolate.
Dark concertos.
Mm-hmm.
Like just a celebration cookie.
I love
graham
those though.
Chocolate
maybe not
on top.
Even,
where do you?
Yeah, them? Like as cookies, they're great.
Mm-hmm.
But
you,
like
you,
to make
don't
cookies.
Know what or where you're talking about. Where do you get these?
It's a five star any five star restaurant that serves only the highest of quality products. That
serves.
I
guess I'm not a five star person.
They're box cookies.
have no idea what this is.
You get them in the grocery store. They come in an orange box.
I have no fucking clue.
It's like, it comes
they're
like a cracker.
They're just graham crackers.
It's just
like, with
it's
chocolate
just
like
on
it. Yes, and it has like a design on the top
yeah,
as well.
It's
yeah,
not
oh,
like
I
a
totally
castle.
Know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So like, they're
suggested. Which one of those dots did it take to connect you?
Shut up. Don't talk about it. Just keep going. And you understand, that's all that matters.
Yeah, they're advertised for use of s'mores. And it's not, it's just not correct in my opinion. There's not
oh, yeah.
enough chocolate on there.
That's how this
got so, Sunny D. Okay, we move on. with
what?
Two...
No.
Wait,
five Alive, actually.
Five Alive?
Three against one here.
Five Alive is a shitty jive. Sunny D.
Says you, bitch.
Sunny D brings children glee. I think we know who's
you
the winner.
Oh, yeah, that works.
But
that
what?
They said Adam and Eve, not Adam and Steven. There's nothing gayer than rhyming.
Oh.
All right, next question.
I'm kidding, gays
are with $2, I buy a... No, you're not. But $2, I buy a mug. I go to America, where the mug is worth $3 and sell it. I then return with my extra dollar. But
I don't
did
quite
I
understand
make,
this.
Did I make money? No, he doesn't. He doesn't make money because he had $2 in the first place.
Yeah.
He spent the $2 on a mug, and he sold it. He made a dollar, but he originally had $2. So
yeah.
To make money, you have to make a
does
profit.
So he lost
conversion
dollar.
Rates also?
Well, no. First of all, it costs money to get money to convert it.
Yeah.
Secondly,
not much, though. Not much.
Enough that it would be, like, we're only talking
yeah,
about $3.
No, but not even, though.
What?
I made money when I converted, like, $500 American for my dad. To Canadian, and I made so much cash on that. Like, he was like, yeah, you can keep, like, whatever, and I'll give you, like, a percentage for doing it for me. I was like, cool. And when I handed it to him, he was like, cool, I'll give you, like, $400. I was like, yeah, all right, cool,
so
yeah,
like,
totally, what?
So like, downsize the $500 US, downsize that to $3, and I'm pretty sure the cost to get it converted is still significant enough that
yeah.
it's going to affect the total. And so, but regardless, like, off of the bat, no, he doesn't make money, because I guess he makes money, he doesn't make a profit.
He
I'm assuming
might
that's what he
be
meant
able
by
to.
That. Yeah. So, I don't think so. I don't know. I don't
maybe.
Think so. I think it depends on what he means by make money. Because
yeah.
he means, like, make money as in make profit, then no.
No.
If he means make money as in, like, he creates money, that's the government's job. I hope not.
you could make, like, a dollar
you,
or two,
you
which
dirty,
I guess could be profit.
Dirty commie. Well, if he's making, if he's creating false currency, he's therefore lowering the Canadian dollar, which means he's taking my money. He's taking my money, the dirty commie, okay?
Peter, is he taking my money?
Where is your wallet?
Oh.
After he gives you a back alley blowjob.
I'm not okay with this, Peter. So not okay with this, Peter. Peter, what?
Do you think cats... We're going to get through like a bunch of these and then we're going to write stories. Do you think cats enjoy music or do you think they really hate it?
Depends on the genre.
I think cats don't give a fuck.
Yeah, and different.
I don't think cats care about anything except for occasionally like... Showing
food.
Its butthole to you. Because
my
cat...
Maybe angry, it'll pee in your pants.
I think cats like music, but they like to make it seem like they don't.
They're too cool.
Yeah, exactly. They're like, I'm just going to sit here in the sun, and I don't care what you put on. But then if it's like a certain genre, they'll flip the fuck out and just jump and run out of the room.
Those people are the worst. They put on whatever you want, and then you put some, like, some T-Swift the bay, and fucking, they're like, not Taylor Swift, and you put, like, I don't know.
If cats had a genre preference, what do you think it would be?
Musical.
Okay, sorry.
Just cats?
Cats.
A genre.
Cats the musical?
Cats the musical. They only listen to songs about them.
No, just cats.
Just cats.
Every
just
answer
cats.
I give them a
cat
should be about how self-centered they are.
Okay.
I have that
of
on
mice
vinyl
and
somewhere.
Mice of men?
Ghost mice?
Mouse.
Modest
dead,
mouse?
Dead mouse?
Dead mouse? Modest
dead
mouse?
Dead
mouse
5?
Yeah.
So EDM and punk.
That's it.
Yeah.
For some reason, they love all these mouse bands.
Alt, yeah.
Who knows?
Because they, you know.
Cats.
They're hungry for music.
They love it so much.
I don't know. What's a cat band? I don't know. Oh, Cat Stevens.
Cat Power.
Oh yeah.
Cat Stevens.
Thundercats. There's a funk band called Thundercats.
Also, He-Man and the Thundercats.
What can be some ponies to pass out in a...
What is it?
What's going on? Hey, 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 hey
a poor enough job there that we can't get sued for copyright.
We don't want to say that's our song. Bring us down.
We get to court, and then they play it for the judge, and the judge would be like, why are you bringing this to me? This sounds like nothing.
Like,
yeah.
They did such a bad job, like, what?
Yeah. This sounds like girls on spring break.
Anyway.
I was showing this in the courtroom.
I'm not sexist, but I'm not sexist. Anyway.
Okay, good.
Alright, put L's. Anyway. Do I think cats really enjoy music? No. But if they did, they would listen to cat-related pun bands.
Yes.
Catcore.
Always catcore. Battle Cats? What? Oh, shameless plug?
That's all they play? Yeah, that's all I play.
That's all they would play. You don't need fingers to play Battle Cats, you need one point.
Do they play it, or is it their, like, secret nightlife where they're actually part of Battle Cats?
You've changed the entire conversation.
And is it a dance battle? Is it a dance Battle Cat?
Peter, don't tempt me.
Is Battle Cats the app, like, an inaccurate representation of actual Battle Cats?
That's how cats fight?
Like, yeah. like
who knows?
Grown men in, like, trench coats and fedoras, like, glue gun or like scotch tape or some shit, like axes to their cats, and there's an arena and the cats like have to scratch at each other.
It's like cockfights where they tie like
whoa, I don't know how many cockfights you've been in, buddy.
The kinds with birds.
Duh, well, anyway.
They're terrible. They tie hooks to the back of feet and they cut birds and shit. It's bad.
But then they
eat them, so I guess it's okay.
They eat birds?
They eat the chicken, yeah. But I guess, you know, I understand. I get it. One chicken dies.
All birds are chicken? Is that...
Yes.
What I... Okay.
All
yes.
birds taste like chicken?
Practically, why would I differentiate? I mean, I'm eating it.
If it tastes like chicken, keep on licking. If it tastes like choke, get the fuck out.
Aaron's mom, a friend of ours' mom, she went back to being, what's the correct word for non-vegetarian? Just, I don't know. She was a vegetarian for a really long time, and then she went back.
Omnivore is
normal.
Yeah.
Norm? And then she went back to not being.
Freak!
She was a vegetarian for a really long time, and then she went to not being a vegetarian, and she ate chicken for the first time. And because she's clever as hell, she was like, tastes like tofu.
Uh-huh.
Well, I'm glad she flavored her tofu properly.
Mm-hmm.
Well,
I kind of like tofu.
I really like tofu, honestly.
Yeah.
I like
you
food.
Ditto. And, like, I can make myself like tofu if I cook it properly.
Yeah,
you know?
If it's,
just
like, in a dish and you, like, cook it properly and season it properly, whatever, it's great.
Yeah. No, tofu tastes like whatever you want it to.
Yeah.
It's
like the ditto.
Yeah.
Of, food.
I don't know. Everything
it's
tastes like ketchup for me.
If you take, like, 1 pound of tofu and 1 pound of something that tastes really good, it just becomes 2 pounds of something that tastes really good.
Yeah,
you know?
Yeah, you get it. You know, you just put enough flavoring into the tofu,
exactly.
And suddenly it's like, wow, this is chicken.
Yeah.
I'm not even a vegetarian.
Yeah.
How many things would you say about ketchup on?
Peter?
How many things do you put ketchup on? Don't you ask my question first?
Me? Not many.
Okay, Cleo, how many things do you put
ketchup on? No, Peter, you're the next one. Answer, how many things do you put ketchup on?
No, we'll go around the circle, we'll make it
fine,
fair.
Fine,
I don't even put ketchup on my fries most of the time.
I only put ketchup on things when I'm offered ketchup.
Everything but, like,
everything.
Cereal.
Fucking everything. I was in a random store, and I saw a shelf full of, like, ketchup bottles and a giant ketchup dispenser behind it. All labeled Heinz, very clearly ketchup. I took a photo, I sent it to him, and he just said, this made me so happy.
It did, it made my day. It was great. I don't know, I want to be there in that aisle. I want to be, like, I don't want
to
live there.
That was Crave Burger, Peter. Go to Crave Burger, you'll see a lot of Heinz.
That's sick.
Favorite restaurant?
I don't even know, really, I don't know how to describe the taste of ketchup other than to say ketchup, but, like, Heinz specifically,
I'm all about
it's a pretty lazy definition, but, like,
yeah.
I don't know, I
don't
know,
I
just...
I don't know, if they don't know what ketchup is, they should tune out and look it up.
I mean, Heinz is the best ketchup.
In my opinion, in my very not-so-humble, I'm a connoisseur.
Lots of people's opinions.
Okay, I have a question.
Go ahead.
How do you guys eat your Kraft dinner, specifically, like, utensil,
pepper,
condiments, etc.?
I eat it straight out of the pot.
Mm-hmm.
I just drown that shit like a kitten in water with ketchup.
Okay.
And I,
Spoon or fork?
And I use a spoon.
Okay, what about you? you?
I use a fork.
Fork?
I use a fork, but I shovel it, like, to the side.
Okay.
That's
do
how
you
eat.
Generally put ketchup on it, or...
I use chopsticks.
I eat it either plain, always with a fork, and if I put ketchup, I put sriracha in with the ketchup. Mm. Go.
Pepper with a fork.
Pepper.
Oh, yeah, yeah, pepper.
You're a pretty peppery guy.
I like pepper.
You look
solid.
Like
it's
you look
solid.
Like
it's kind of spicy, not even. I had a pepper soup once. I had a pepper soup once at like a girlfriend's house. Her dad made this pepper soup, and like her and her mom were like, "This is gross," and I was sitting there like, "This is great." Like, I don't know what you two are talking about. Like I was looking at him like, "Dude, you're the like make me this soup some more. I'll eat it." Like, not
soup.
Even thinking about it.
Soup is an underrated food, in my opinion. Soup is, like, my favorite.
Sorry.
I love food.
No.
It's a good starter.
I'd argue
soup?
That...
Soup, yeah.
I'd say it's pretty on point as
like
far as rated.
Squash soup or, like, pumpkin soup in the fall. It's, like,
ew.
Oh, I love it. It's so
ew.
Good.
It has, like, the texture of baby vomit. You sicko.
I don't think you're making it right.
You gotta, like, no, well, first of all, my baby vomit? Do you think I'm making my baby vomit right? I take the finest of babies, I feed them raw food... that they're going to vomit up, and then I just, like, bloop, for a visual, bloop.
Alright, so you're pressing, like, a button, right? So which part of the baby is this?
Well, I don't know, I poked the stomach, I just don't, like, stop at a poke, I just kind of sort of jab, really.
You need to follow through.
Punch this baby in the face?
Or else the baby will just spit up a little.
I shake it a lot, and hope to God I never
you
get
just
sin.
You just make sure it doesn't cry anymore.
Mm-hmm.
Why won't it stop? This worked.
Oh,
this worked in home ec. I don't know.
I don't know. The doctor slapped him when he came out. I just.
What's your favorite condiment? Like, what's your favorite sauce? Would you say? It's not a question.
Either honey mustard or sriracha.
Sriracha. Like a.
There's an N on there. Now.
As a person
yes.
who consumes a lot of sriracha, and you like to take that person and like.
Use them as a condiment.
I use them.
And then
I
melt them in a pot of
yes.
sriracha sauce, so
yes.
it's like double the sriracha.
Yes, it's super spicy.
It's like only
it's crazy
eating
spicy.
Cows that eat like healthy shit, as opposed to
cows
like
that
cow shit.
Cows and get. Mad cow disease, it's only eating mad cow disease.
Well, like,
cows.
The conditions that most large companies, cows, like the slaughterhouses and stuff, they end up eating, like, their own shit, other cows' shit, dead cow bodies. Like, it's pretty awful. It's pretty terrible.
How
I
do
still
they get mad cow disease? What gives them mad cow disease?
I don't know the science behind mad cow disease.
Google it!
You're so
Google
concerned.
Google it, Peter! Google it! I want to know what's causing my meat to give me mad cow disease.
Well, do you have mad cow disease?
Sorry, what?
Don't
next
have
question.
A, don't have a don't have a cow, man.
Personally, I like salsa.
Is that a condiment? Oh, it goes well with rice, actually.
Salsa goes
rice.
Well with everything. They have this habanero salsa. I don't know what it is, like, organic.
Yeah. Lasagna?
I think, maybe.
Lasagna sauce? It's from,
it's like, organic.
Lasagna sauce? There's a lot of peas, and,
I think
it's
that's
really,
got it. It's
really,
really
good.
Spicy.
Yeah. I didn't
wait,
find it.
It must
well,
be a different one.
I know, yeah.
Yeah.
I didn't find it too spicy. It was like, it was
okay,
kind of
no,
like.
We're definitely talking about different
here,
sauces.
Let me find a picture. But it went really, really well in rice. When
it's
chicken.
Nice. Yeah, sauce to chicken and rice.
So I put some of lasagna.
Anyone cares my
sriracha? Sriracha? Sorry, did you
sorry. I actually enjoy the condiment.
That's
not
the one I was
looking
okay.
Who consume the condiment.
Weird.
Well, I think
yeah,
I
got
it.
Yeah,
try it though.
Yeah,
that's
what am I thinking?
Like,
I don't remember mine.
You're odd.
But
you're
like, I like
there.
Heinz 57 sauce. It's like, it's
yeah,
like,
that's
I like
shit.
That.
What is Heinz 57?
Like, you've been putting that on everything.
Yeah, it's, I don't know, it's ketchup and then Heinz 57. It's like good. Excuse me, good AP sauce, or like H1 sauce.
Oh, okay.
I really, HP sauce?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where's your AP sauce?
HP.
I think it's A1 and HP.
A1 and HP.
Yes.
We're both kind of right.
I bet you if
so
I search.
Fight!
I bet you if I search AP sauce, it's gonna come up. It sure does.
Advanced placement.
Am I
oh,
right?
Well.
Right?
Just let it go, just let it go.
Okay.
Never let it go.
It's agent of provocators.
Your face is an agent of provocators.
Ho ho ho!
Agent?
What?
Provocators?
Ho ho ho!
Our next question is. The next question is mayonnaise an instrument? Patrick Starr.
Yes.
Okay.
An instrument of what? Like an instrument
you
of.
You can make it an instrument of
passion.
I want to say
death, mass,
enjoyment,
something.
Suicide, genocide. Fratricide.
It's all the sides, I know.
Sodomicide, Sodicide. I don't know. Because when God killed Sodom and, what was the other one? Is it Ali? Sodom and Sodom? Sodom, anyway. When he turned an entire... when he turned an... Let's not turn this into a religious thing. When God turned... when God turned an entire town, Sodom, to a pillar of salt. Or like, he smote it? Smited? Smote?
Classic Old Testament.
Smitten?
Good old.
When God
good old
was
God.
Smitten. When Gomorrah's... Oh, it was Sodom and Gomorrah. When Gomorrah's wife turned around, the wife turned into a pillar of salt.
Oh, no.
And that's my favorite sauce.
Oh, mama.
So, no, mayonnaise is not an instrument. No, no,
mama.
No, Patrick. Mayonnaise is not an instrument.
Can anyone get that right?
Yeah. Brecken, okay, well, I say the names, anyway,
it's
whatever.
Stop saying it, Peter.
you mad, bro?
I'm so fired
like,
right now.
Generally?
You square up, Peter?
God, I wasn't.
And now I'm just suddenly angry.
I don't know.
Peter,
like,
you
want to
square up?
No, on a serious note, do you consider yourself a mad person? Like, do you, like...
On a day-to-day?
Yeah.
Very angry. Upset over nothing. Like literally the stupidest shit in the world. You on your end are like, all right, whatever. And on my end, I'm like, you piece of garbage,
driving. Piece
of shit person. Like in my mind, just
driving especially. Like someone could do the most like mediocre menial shit ever.
Start screaming at them. Where the fuck's your blinker, bitch?
Or like if they take like a second too long and like driving out like into the green light or whatever, like
like you're behind them, it turns green.
Like,
you're
what
like,
are you blind? You're an old. What are, you're like an old deaf
decrepit
dog drinking a smoothie while driving. Yeah, I feel like I'm the exact opposite. I'm like too understanding about everything. Like, if somebody does, like, some stupid freaking move while they're driving, I'm like, you know, they had their reasons. Like, I just won't get
like,
mad
rushed.
At people.
I'm pretty angry.
Man.
I'm a mad person sometimes. I mean, I won't be mad to a person usually, except for if they're James Fay and their Dr. Pepper gets shaken up.
I cleaned it up.
And then when he opened it, it spilled on the ground, and instead of like putting it over the sink, which was to his immediate like right or left or something, he just stood there, put it around his crotchal area,
and
had this face like.
Peter, there's two sides to every story.
Okay.
I was wearing a shark onesie at the time, and the way it works is your hand pokes out of the fin, but not, like, at the edge of the fin, like, earlier on, so half your fin is just bobbing around. And I was scared if I turned to the left, it would get caught on the counter, and the pop would spill all over it instead, and ruin it.
Yeah,
okay, well.
Yeah. He just took precautions.
Yeah, okay, so, chill. so in response to the question,
are
I'd
you
assume,
a mad person?
I would no. I'd assume they were talking to someone else because only like three people in my life have ever called me bro.
Are those your brothers?
And no, two of them were casual acquaintances, and one I'm just assuming somebody's probably called me that by now.
Your brothers have never called you bro.
Maybe Rourke. I think Zachary.
I saw the Christmas pictures, by the way. I wonder your profile.
Oh, yeah, where we took Rourke's face and got a stranger to hold it in our family picture.
Was that a stranger?
Yeah, I don't know who it was. He was just waiting in line behind us. And we're like, hey, can you hold this in front of your face and pretend you're my
brother?
Where
was Rourke?
He's in Japan. Hello, Rourke. He's in Kyoto.
He's looking at a lot of funny Santa pictures. Me and Aaron, for instance, dress up as goth.
That
was a lot of fun.
That should be like the picture for this podcast.
We saw like
I had a Photoshop picture of Rorik's face on Santa.
Yeah.
Wow, me and Aaron are goth.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
That's gonna be the part.
We'd seen like a picture that somebody had like went around the internet and it was just like a goth family, like they weren't being ironic or whatever, but they went to see Santa and they had like completely blank expressions on their face. And we were like, hey, we should do that. Or I was like, hey, we should do that, and I got Aaron on board with it, and, yeah, we went to see Santa as a goth, and during the process, he grabbed both our asses and told us that he had a cousin, a niece, who had a tattoo of a peacock that started at her neck and went down to her ass, and,
like
that's mall Santa.
Like her anus?
Oh my god.
He didn't specify.
You should ask.
Did you not ask?
No, I'm sorry. I should have followed up.
You ruined it. You should have known that,
yeah,
first off, that your friends would start a podcast for this story to happen. And secondly, the foresight to know whether or not this peacock was, in fact, a pea... First off, was it a pea fowl? Was it a pea hen?
No.
Or a peacock?
It was a peacock.
So, like, colored, nice...
Yes.
Okay.
Beautiful, like, turquoise, greens, the whole shebang. Yeah, that was the deal. All
right, well...
Yeah. His niece.
Well, his niece could have made some better decisions, I guess.
Yeah.
Go back this year and ask him.
I will. Hopefully it's the same guy. Maybe
yeah.
he got wired for
grabs
telling
your ass.
Yeah.
It's been the same elf for the past, like, 6 years. So.
Maybe he got fired for telling people about his niece's tattoo, though.
Yeah,
or grabbing
their
asses.
Yeah, that...
Your go-to was, like, a story this guy told.
I feel like you should just assume that all Santa's Santas are perverts, though.
I feel like you could just show up...
Seemed like bad Santa. Like,
Santa.
Yeah.
He was like that. He was, like, had a little flask of, like, scotch or something
yeah.
in his Santa suit.
Mm-hmm.
And you just get drunk.
Like, Santa's little.
Did we totally lose Nat?
Lose grabbing a beer. Nat!
Oh.
Yeah, I'm hurrying.
Grabbing a beer?
Grab one.
Grab a beer.
What? Last one.
Beer bottle of Coca-Cola.
Oh.
For Samson. It's for Samson.
Okay, yeah. He has a
problem.
Samson does have a problem.
Samson's problem is he's missing right now.
That's okay.
What?
No, just ask your question.
Alright. Why should I ask you a question?
Why?
Is the next question.
That's technically a question, so.
Ah, you've already done it. You've lost. We win.
Exactly.
You asked us a question.
Horses,
exactly.
Yay.
You need an answer.
Horses,
yeah.
Yay or nay?
Yay. Why nay?
Because
horses
is nay.
Well,
this is a fair point, but why is that a negative thing? They have an opinion. That's a good thing, right?
Horses?
It's punny.
Horses are the worst.
I don't understand.
Horses would be terrifying if they didn't eat, like, fruit and
mm-hmm.
what they eat. Like, they would be so scary.
Yeah, a horse.
If they were carnivorous in any way, even.
Horses with fangs are
pretty
scary.
Yeah,
black horses with red eyes, terrifying.
Or, like,
that's
horses with, mean. Like, people feet instead of hooves.
That's
weird.
What's the inverse of that? Centaurs.
Centaurs?
Yeah.
More like...
Wait, which ones are centaurs?
Horse body...
And minotaurs are, like, the other way, but with
yeah.
the wolf.
Okay. Yeah. Completely different animal.
No, they resemble
a bull
other.
And a horse are completely different animals.
Yeah. They're part of the same family, whatever.
They have hooves.
Close enough.
And a head,
yeah.
They're both kosher.
Oh! Good for you, Peter.
Yeah.
Oh, but you know what my uncle told me about those eggs that we have in our fridge?
What?
His hen is brooding, so we may find half a chicken
oh.
in one of those.
Oh, great.
Like a little baby chicken just in one of those eggs when you crack it open to, like, make an omelet. Baby chicken.
And when you came
fetus?
In with those eggs?
Like a fetus. Oh my god, I'd be so amped.
I have 2 cartons of eggs that you can crack open if you want to cook all of those for me. There may be a baby chicken in one of them.
On steak and eggs?
When you came in with those
yeah.
eggs initially, it was freaking hilarious because, like, Peter was like, oh, Nat, why do you have so many eggs? And you were like, they're my uncle's. And it sounded like you were trying to cover up something
yeah,
so
like,
bad.
Like
Nat, what are you doing with a pound of cocaine? That's for a friend.
Yeah,
my uncle's.
These were just milk cartons full of guns.
Yeah.
I swear to God, I've never saw these eggs before in my life. They're not my eggs. They're, that must have been planted by my uncle.
I do not know that hen.
When in reality, my uncle has a bunch of chickens that gave me, you know, he gave me 2 cartons full of eggs because of those chickens.
I did not
which
have sex relationships with those chicks.
It just took me so long to get it out. I was like,
What? How did this happen?
My
why
brain,
do I
where,
have
where
my
go?
Brain like had to register? Be like, eyes, look at these eggs. How the fuck did you get those? Oh,
real question.
Right, this.
Does anybody in your family have any affiliation with ducks whatsoever?
Yes, great like uncles and shit. Great,
just
great
uncles. Like no
but
one
no,
in your
no,
immediate
no one
family,
in my immediate family.
About ducks.
No, not at all. All right, for those who need to
you're
need
about
to be updated, I have to update. Deuce, D-O-O-K-S, in North English. Apparently, according to some dude who contacted my dad after he saw his show, was like, I'm related to you. And was like, in North England, Dukes means keeper of the duck, which apparently I found out means leader of the ducks, which means we were duck farmers. I had this one family member that wasn't a duck farmer, though. He wanted to be a sailor, and so he left one day to sail off and become a sailor. But then he eventually came to Canada and, you know, stayed with the duck farmers, I guess, until he died. And when he died, the owner of, like, Carnival Cruises, or, like, one of the billion-dollar cruise lines, just showed up at his funeral, and everyone was like, what the fuck? And he was like, I'm just here to show my respects to my friend. And apparently, this Dukes guy, at some point, met this, like, guy who owned a billion-dollar cruise line, befriended him somehow. I don't know. Dukes do that shit. We make random friends. And then this guy showed up at his funeral and was like, you were a cool dude. I wanna, you know I got to say goodbye. And it's like, alright, cool. So right on. Sounds rad. So, Peter likes ducks. My name is Keeper of the Ducks. My family were duck farmers, except for somebody. One person. There are still duck farmers in, like, related to me somehow, but...
Where would we be without ducks?
It'd be an interesting
That's
history.
That's a good question.
Yeah,
duvets? Wouldn't exist. Probably.
Dude, like...
Good duvets.
So, I have a question.
Isn't that goose feathers?
I have a question. You mentioned there was a distinction there. At one point, it meant, like, keeper of the ducks. Another meant leader of the ducks.
Okay.
So what
does
a duck
leader
do?
I think it's just a translation there.
No, there was a...
Yeah, but it was like, what would a leader do differently than a keeper
of
the ducks?
No, but we Googled it. We started looking because my grandmother is a Chisholm, and the Chisholms were a clan of Irish people, I believe it is.
Right.
Yes.
You look vaguely Irish. You're freak.
But I'm also kind of Scottish, so I don't know where I come from. A little bit of everything.
Yeah, a little.
But,
and nobody loves you.
Oh. Exactly. You know, but
sorry, nowhere.
Just add
nowhere.
That on to any
Everywhere just hates me. I'm North English, so I'm still kind of like Scottish, but then I'm also directly Scottish, so, like, the southern UK just despises me.
Well, my
I'm also Irish, so, like, that's another, like, addition to people just hating me.
My arms love you.
Your face loves me every night.
My bed sheets.
If these walk a duck.
Should we?
Yeah, you want
probably.
You want
privacy?
But no, but apparently in the Chisholms, my grandmother's clan, there was a clan leader. His two sons ended up joining the British Empire as generals and fighting against him when he was the leader of, like, a Scottish rebellion.
Dicks.
I know, right? Like, what dicks? What fucking assholes? But, like, I guess that's my family. Opportunists through and through. Just like, oh, I can win in this situation. I'm gonna take it.
I said, be the worst person, but I guess I'll win. I don't know.
Like, on the battlefield, you're like, hey, you, Dad. You're a dick, son. I'm gonna murder you. You're a fucking asshole. No, I'm gonna, like, literally, I'm gonna stab you with a sword.
I don't think you can take, I'm gonna murder you, like, to be a figure of speech. Like, I'm gonna murder you, like...
In a video game, maybe.
I'm gonna murder you, as in, like, murder my meaty pussy. I mean,
if you say, I'm gonna kill you, people say that quite often without actual intent.
Oh, like, you got me wet, I'm gonna kill you, and then you cut the photo.
You said you wanted to kill me, like, 20 minutes ago, so...
Ooh.
When did I say I wanted
when
to kill
when
you?
When I spilled,
I said I wanted to end your life, which is a distinct difference.
I don't even think
what
so.
What is that difference?
I feel like if anything can be taken more seriously, it's I'm gonna end your life than I want to kill
no,
you.
No, because, like, killing is a direct, like, I don't know, because life could be, like, social life. And I'm gonna post pictures
James.
Of you pooping on me.
Grab my barbecue.
I got distracted.
Sorry, my barbecue might not
so
be
so, horses, nay.
Neigh?
Horses neigh.
I already said that.
Your ass neighs.
Horses neigh. Funny story that I don't think I'm allowed to tell, so...
What is the story?
It's
tell
a story about Mackenzie.
I don't care.
Cool, cool. Alright, so... so, sorry, Mackenzie. Anyway, so...
Mackenzie, surprise!
Mackenzie, surprise! You have them.
James, never mind, I found it, come back!
Okay. So, okay, so, Mackenzie... this happened, like, within... I don't know, I'm gonna say 5 years, because that's pretty big and hard to mess up. I don't know, I think it's within 5 years. It was recent-ish. And apparently she was on, like, a tall wall or something. I don't know. Anyway, there was a horse nearby, and this horse came up to Mackenzie and suckled upon her bare knee. And Mackenzie couldn't get away, because she was on a really high wall. And she wasn't just gonna jump on the horse. So the horse was, like suckling upon her kneecap. And apparently popped a boner. Popped a horse boner while, like, suckling. And then apparently, like,
boner?
Mackenzie sketched out and doesn't like horses anymore.
Little horsey boner is not...
What?
Let's all tell horse stories.
No, I have a question.
I had a sheep story.
Horse stories. I didn't say sheep.
Well, I know, but that's what I have to offer, Peter. If you want to hear it, you can let me know.
Did you fuck a sheep?
No. Had nothing to do with that.
Should we talk about the goat question?
About my all sister right. Knowing the goat that saves all of your drunken history?
No. So, James Fay has this question.
I didn't come up with the question.
He just asked people. And so the question is, would you rather have everybody think you fucked a goat, but not actually fucked a goat, or have fucked a goat, but nobody know
but
you?
But nobody knows!
Yeah, you just did it. But you have to live with that.
So,
every time you see a goat, you think about a different
way. I'd
fuck
a goat.
But
like,
as a girl, would have to be fucked by a goat in this situation.
I don't think goats last very long.
With
and you can put it in the
but like if you're telling them says like you know like man like what I just fucked a goat, people are gonna be like, you know what, I've always wondered what fucking goat would be like.
Kind of like you can put your dick in anything.
Yeah, you can stumble upon somehow fucking a goat while you're drunk or whatever or
yeah.
on drugs or something.
No,
it's way more explainable
wrong.
Way than being
like
yeah
take,
I got
like,
in this situation
take, like, or people I've heard tell early puberty stories like one time like I fucked a couch. Right?
Yeah.
But that's a lot different than, like...
One time I stumbled into a goat vagina.
Yeah.
Dick first, naked with a
well,
boner.
Is it easier to explain away, hey, one time I fucked a goat accidentally or on purpose or whatever,
I don't
want to
hear that shit.
Then
it's,
I've been fucked
you know
by a goat.
You know
when
you think
she was
like,
beautiful...
It's hard enough to find a human vagina with, like, ready and prepared with your, like... sober and with pants on, literally like stumbling through drunk, accidentally wandering into a goat's bed. I don't know. As a male, I do not like. Because if everybody thinks you did, you basically have.
Yeah.
Like, that's rumors.
No matter how hard you're gonna fight it. Everyone thinks you've done it.
It doesn't really matter.
Yeah,
if you
that's
fight
the
it or
law
not.
Of Michael Jackson.
So.
Exactly.
Although we did do it. so, you paired the parents, what, for nothing? I think not. So, I would fuck the goat. I don't know. Just because I would rather, like, forget about that myself, I don't know, through means of chemicals or, I don't know. I would have to sit long and hard,
right next to a goat.
Now, a more interesting question would be, just for a blanket, would you rather get fucked by a goat? Because, like, would I rather take a goat dick in the ass?
Is a totally different question.
Yeah. Yeah. So, I mean, that would be more valid.
And,
for,
like, if this was a lesbian goat, and we could do it that way, it
would you rather get eaten out by a goat?
Would you
rather scissor? Would you rather
yeah.
scissor a goat? Would you rather go
no.
down on a goat?
Don't tell you anything.
No. All of that's no.
I don't know if anyone on the podcast like definitively heard that because like there was a lot of talking at the time, but I want James Fay to repeat what you just said.
Ghost lead anything.
cool. So not everybody got it. that was
next,
too good.
Next question.
Let's move on.
I
don't know. Are we out of questions?
I have one.
No.
We have to tell
James
stories.
Has one, okay. All
right. So, I just want your opinion on this. Because recently there was a sensory deprivation sort of spa opened around here.
Oh, the blind. Is it the restaurant?
I haven't been
there's a restaurant, for, like, quote unquote restaurant for the blind.
No,
and
no, no,
so
no,
they
no,
blindfold
no.
you and it's pitch black and
no,
stuff.
No, no, no.
Really?
It's a chamber. It's like a...
like a tanning
deformation
bed.
Chamber.
Yeah, yeah, it's
like
filled with the salt, salt
like,
water
yeah,
stuff,
and
you just
like
kind of float in it.
It's at body temperature, so it feels like
it
nothing.
Feels like you're just floating in nothingness, and
yeah.
It's pitch black and you can't hear.
And a goat wanders in, you stumble into it.
I don't know where I was going with that. I just thought it was interesting.
Suddenly you're fucking a goat. That's where you went with this.
I don't know. Have you ever like floated into a pool
are you
and
to
the
tell
pool
us
is
something?
Still?
You
fucking
goat.
I
was kind
of
I was kind of wondering how long you think you would last in something like that.
Inside a goat.
Well, I
don't
know.
Just
a twitchy person.
Up the Facebook feeds and
inside the sensory deprivation
knows.
Chamber, like in lukewarm water, just laying there. I get
yeah,
it. I get.
You start hallucinating.
Oh, like a oh that's in a movie though. That's an
it's an actual thing here.
Like it's for
so
like
down.
Burn patients, right?
It's
I,
for anything. I'm
hey,
pretty
you
sure
can
you
go
can
there
just,
like,
do it. Yeah, you have the money.
But
yeah.
It's like,
I mean, I do it. I think like I don't know.
Like
I'm really twitchy, so I feel like I'd stay there for 20 minutes and then be like, all right, I'm done. Bye.
Yeah. Well, there's this thing where it's like it tricks your mind into thinking like it, it's for burn patients to if they can't like physically put something on like a stumpy stub or whatever that like is a burn. And they want you to, like, psychologically be fine with it, so the pain would stop or whatever. They put you in this, like, this bed of water, and then they put something over your eyes or whatever, and then it makes you think, like, you're on a mountaintop, and you have, like, snow in your hands and stuff like that. It's really interesting, because it's, like...
intense.
Yeah, well, it takes away the psychological aspect of the pain, which, like, begs the question, is physical pain a thing, or is it... Well, I guess because like there's a physical stimuli, but like is the...
yeah there's a there's a nervous stimuli. There's like you know directly.
But like
is
physical pain valid if you can't interpret it?
Well, I would say no because you know you,
well, you
yourself
yeah, you, have to set up
you like you know if I cannot interpret physical pain, I get stabbed. Doesn't matter. I can't interpret physical pain.
Yeah, pain isn't like the action. It's what you feel.
Exactly. Yeah. So
if given the option, and this is like probably a common question, but if given the option, would you remove pain?
No.
God, no.
Really?
Is there for a
reason? I don't know. Maybe because we're big boys.
No.
Like,
okay, that's not true. Appendixes aren't there for a reason. They were there for a reason.
No,
so
it is there
the
for
next...
a reason.
What?
It's the same reason you have just a sense of touch in general. And
it's
so that you can...
No, but I mean, like, specifically...
So you can
pain.
Live,
like,
Vita.
Like, how about we
so
say, like,
live.
Our threshold for pain
I still,
is
I can still
so
sense
much
I
ridiculously...
Me,
I'd leave it.
Cause
no,
I
but you can just sense it touching you, but you don't know it's hurting you.
Then
but
no.
But if, okay, if I don't know pain, I'm assuming I can't feel it all, because...
No, that's what
yeah,
I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. Your threshold for pain is higher. I'm not saying you're numb
just
nothing, all the
time. Nothing bothers
I still
you
wouldn't,
in that
I
sense.
Still wouldn't, just because, I don't know, James will respect this, like, as
yeah,
a dancer,
yeah, no.
You need to know what your body's doing, so you need to be able to feel it at any moment in time.
So
if something goes wrong and your body goes,
yeah.
stop what you're doing right now, you need to know that so you
yeah.
can... literally stop on a dime.
I think
yeah.
I would. I think I would. I think the only downside would be no kinky shit.
Well, I mean, you still could. You just won't feel it.
Exactly.
Fair.
I want to feel the champagne bottle in my asshole.
I want to know what love is.
Which is a champagne bottle.
Show
in the butt.
Me.
It's
sing-along. It's the sing-along episode. We have a musical episode. Yay!
I think I'd ignore pain so I can finally stop feeling the sadness.
Doesn't
no one left?
Is it New York?
Is it
New York?
Because we
laughed for us. I wish I had my book. It's something along the lines of, like, it's the theory that if you
no,
cannot know, like, sadness, you
I'll
can't know
mistake.
True happiness.
I believe it.
True, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, there's a Tyler, the Creator line, which
oh,
is odd
too.
Enough. Yeah, the IFHY, it's like, craziest who makes me the happiest can make me the saddest.
Yeah.
So, like, someone who can make you feel things emotionally, although it's, like, sometimes good, feeling bad is also pretty shitty. So,
yeah.
like, if
yeah.
I don't know, if I alleviate all sources of pain, if my threshold for pain is higher, I would be emotionally a different person, but I could deal with each other. So,
yeah.
Trust would also be a lot different. Because, I mean...
Well, trust wouldn't even be a concept. Because,
yeah,
like, you, like trust wouldn't be a...
Because there wouldn't be a threat to it.
Yeah. Because even if your trust is broken, like, you don't feel anything.
That sounds so sad.
That sounds kind of satisfying. Because you wouldn't know what sadness is. Or happiness.
Well, yeah.
But, like, why is that sad? You can't just...
Yeah, if you can't feel sadness, you won't know what it is.
I guess this is the kind of... This is kind of a question, like, the, like, you're an idiot, but you're happy.
or your
this followed goat fucking. This followed goat fucking.
But you know what? It fit perfectly.
Welcome to a couple of ducks. A couple of quackers.
Right.
Who don't give a duck. I
hate
that. That was good.
Welcome, well, that could be a good intro. Welcome to a couple of quackers who don't give a duck.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
I like my isn't on
memo,
but that's just
note.
Me.
No,
that's
like,
just me. I could be wrong.
No,
I could be so wrong.
No,
we could change everything. We could change everything, Peter.
No, it's not like that. I know you are, but what am I?
You're a girl and I'm a guy.
Oh,
never mind.
If you could put anyone on a boat and sail them down the river forever, who would it be?
Donald.
No,
Trump.
I knew you were gonna say it.
Yeah.
No, Donald.
So you just can't go through his presidential campaign.
No,
you ruined a future comic. You ruined someone who's gonna make money off of making fun of
no,
Donald Trump.
No, man, he's already too late. Did you see what he said when Mexico said they were gonna stop working with him?
No.
He's suing them.
he's suing Mexican companies. He's not suing the Mexican government.
No, he's suing companies. No, he's suing companies that
for the Miss America thing, right?
Because they signed contracts that said they apparently had to work them.
This
I don't know these contracts.
Over.
I haven't. I'm sorry. I've talked to Donald Trump for a second because, oh my god, guys!
It's the third podcast in a row that Nat has like creamed himself over Donald Trump.
He's like, so dumb.
Oh, his hair.
He's just so fucking stupid. He fucking, apparently, you know what? He's such a business guy, I bet he did it. Because he has a contract that says that this company can't pull out from airing his Miss Beauty pageant or whatever. And so he's suing them. And he didn't try and, like, be like, they misunderstood me. He said, I've been misrepresented in the media for years, and I've always
you
had
are not allowed
points.
To misunderstand things in, there is no such thing as a misunderstanding of business.
No.
There's
never,
no such thing.
Never.
So
never.
They misunderstood him?
Apparently.
So cool.
According
then,
to him.
Then, well, I mean, if they violated the contract, they violated the contract.
No, I understand that, but, like, if he's saying I've been misrepresented in the media for years, no, they take you
no.
word for word.
No.
We've eaten your word for word up. We've had that shit for breakfast, lunch, and dinner.
That is borderline masturbated to Donald Trump interviews.
Borderline? Excuse
me? The Apprentice comes on, he pops the iron on
his No, I've never seen The Apprentice. I've never seen The Apprentice.
Go,
I won't watch The Apprentice. I won't. I will not. I will not choose to watch Donald Trump in a positive light, so I only watch news interviews.
Nat goes to the mirror and puts on his fake toupee and wanks it with, like, a picture of Donald Trump's
oh,
eye holes
yes,
cut out.
You're so dumb.
Here's, like, a
yes.
facial picture, but, like, eye holes
you're
cut out.
You're just so stupid.
Yeah, well, it's one of those things where, like, Donald Trump is the
would
ultimate...
Would your neighbor speak right now?
I don't know. He's in jail. Anyway,
Yeah, really, his daughter's
so...
there.
Donald Trump is the ultimate reality television star. He is the ultimate, like, there was, you've seen Paris Hilton, you've seen Jersey Shore, you've not seen Donald Trump at his finest until you've seen his recent campaign election. It is incredible. He is a presidential reality television star. That only happens once in a lifetime, folks.
Ever.
Ronald Reagan?
Ever. Mm-hmm. Ronald Reagan was close, but man, like... He was too controversial.
You've beaten Ronald Reagan at something that is terrible. You've accomplished nothing good. Anyway.
You accomplished Ronald Reagan bad.
More like Donald Reagan. Or Ronald Trump.
Ronald Trump
sounds
the man.
Like a Ronald McDonald joke.
Because it has one thing similar.
Yeah.
This is a Ronald McDonald joke.
James Faye, I'm going to end your life.
Oh, please don't.
I won't. I like James a lot.
I'll miss James too much. You're already leaving next year.
Yeah.
He's not leaving.
You don't know, James is going to Germany.
Yeah, he's going. There's a distinct difference between leaving and going.
I'll be back. I have to book my return flight before I leave.
Nice. Good.
So that's my point. I don't know. People seem to think, I don't know.
You're trapped.
You know what I found out? In the UK, because of my cousin. My cousin lived in the UK for a year, got a visa. When your visa runs out, you get deported. No matter what.
Yeah.
Like, like,
Australia.
You're gone.
Australia, we got deported from Australia.
Really?
Because my dad had a work visa, because he had to learn How to,
yeah, do shit.
How to save people's lives. How to beat Australian records for hip replacements. by 2.5 hours.
Nice.
Yeah.
Is your dad, like, a famous Australian doctor, then?
He was on a television show in Australia.
Really?
He was on Bush Doctors.
Whoa.
I can turn
can
up on a
show
clip
me that,
eventually.
Please?
Yeah. Sure. My dad is great. His name is Mike. I won't say his full name because I don't want him to be associated with our terrible antics.
Yeah, really. I don't want to. I've told my parents about this, but I haven't actually given them a link or anything. I'm just, like, kind of hiding it. Like, oh, you don't want to know what I actually am up to.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and he was on Bush Doctors. He went to Dubbo, which is, like, the outback, or part of the outback of Australia. And, oh, it smells so good.
Doesn't it, though?
Grill? Fresh grill?
Oh, man. Charcoal. Charcoal is what it is. I'm having an issue. Like, I'm smelling it.
Yeah,
I'm like, I want to eat it, but I need these 5 more minutes.
Those are really good.
These 5 more... Wasn't it, though?
Yeah.
Like, James, I'm going to have an issue. For those of you who don't know, and you don't because you can't see it, but I got a barbecue. It's like a crotch
high.
It's a dad grill. I'm sitting in a chair, and it's the perfect height for me to just reach over with a spatula and, like, pop the top open. Flip a steak, a nice, well-done steak.
A nice, juicy morsel. Gotta say it like this.
For reference, right now, I'm in the middle of a big parade of testosterone.
I saw a thing with a guy who had biceps that were, like, ludicrously large. Like, they were
literally
6 inches in either
He
way.
Only did curls ever?
Yeah, for some reason. He did a bunch of, like...
Drugs.
Like, yeah, that's what he did. But he got, like, rocks in his biceps, so doctors were like, we're going to have to amputate. And then he was like, I'm going to keep working.
Were they tumors?
I think, probably.
Was this Popeye's the same?
I don't know. It was all in a different language I couldn't quite understand. I can't remember which country they're from.
Well, what country eats rocks?
No, it wasn't, like, it was injected, but it was, like, this, like, silicone.
Oh, was it, like, a stone? Was it, like,
kidney stone type shit.
But like, in your body?
Own.
So
yeah.
It just crystallized body acids and fat.
Yeah.
Well,
and so they were like, we're gonna have to amputate your arm. And then he was like, oh, no, I'm gonna have to give up bodybuilding forever. But,
It could have been, like, I don't know, does lactic acid solidify after a while?
Probably.
There's a lot of lactic acid and stuff like that.
No, it got to the point. He was, like, super thankful that he didn't have to get his arm cut off. But his arms were so grossly big, and he looked like he had tennis balls in his shoulders.
Okay.
We should probably...
No, we still got 20 minutes.
Okay.
We got a while, yeah. We did this for a while. Cleo...
Come on!
You're a guest.
Like,
you're a guest.
Through this podcast.
Okay.
Excuse me, what?
Next question. Oh, actually, no, clearly didn't answer. We haven't really...
What?
If you could put anyone in a boat and sail them down the river forever, who would it be? Would it be Donald Trump?
Yeah, that was my automatic first
What would yours be?
It wouldn't even be Donald Trump, because then I miss out on this.
Exactly, that's what I'm saying. Who would you really
be
signed on it?
Really?
Fucking Michael Bublé. I hate him.
What? My
Why?
Grandmother would
I
cry.
I hate Michael Bublé.
You want to make my grandmother
Why?
Cry, Cleo? Is that what
Why?
You're saying?
No.
Cleo, and
Why
I quote,
you make
and
his grandmother cry?
Hey,
quote,
hey.
Quote, Cleo, I want your grandmother
to cry.
To cry. To tear.
To fucking tear up.
To cry.
To cry.
I don't even want to hear your answer. James Faye?
James Y. Who?
They have to be on I can't, like, go with them? I can't, like, this
No,
no,
it's one person down the river.
It's
a small
adventure.
Boat.
It's That's a one-person boat. A one-way trip.
Yeah, I'm sure coming to be.
Yeah, you gotta.
I have to shave this tomorrow. It's the saddest thing.
Why do you have to shave it?
Because I'm gonna be doing background work on Mr.
This
Bean,
thing
so
is
not. I have to look like a teenager. But to understand my face, think of a rat and what hair it has, including the bald spots. Mostly bald spots. But then, like, think of whatever hair it would have.
Think of an evil villain that frequents a local coffee shop.
But doesn't keep a good schedule on his facial hair. Just
frequently schedule my beard.
No, you have to schedule
a
trim. You have to, like, think, like, in the next
like
two
the
or three days, I'm going to trim this. I'm going to take the razor to this and give it a good little trim, but I don't even have that, because I don't have that kind of consistency in my facial hair.
I just have to wash
it. Like, right there
don't
is where
it
stops.
Don't talk about it.
All right.
I'm getting compliments on my beard now. It's great.
Yeah.
You're seeing what time we're going to have to cut.
No, I'm checking out my steak.
Matt doesn't want anyone to listen to this.
I'm checking out my steak. I'm sorry. I need to make sure it's cooked properly. I have issues.
So, James, who is it?
If I say someone in particular, can it be like right now?
Like my dad.
as soon as I say it, they're gone.
Yes.
Yeah.
Those people from Video Difference who didn't.
Oh, shoot. Man.
Sugar.
Yeah, this guy who burst into Video Difference earlier, and he demanded that like the employee there help him figure out which Star Wars movie came first instead of helping me and the other guy. Well, yeah, so the guy bursts in, and he's like, hey, I want to rent the first Star Wars movie. And the person working is helping someone, and she's like, we have a Star Wars section. Go there. And then the person who she was helping decides to make the situation worse and says, wait, did you mean, like, the first one, like, episode one? Or the first one, like 70s, like,
yes,
the first one
that
was made? And the person was like, oh my god, I'm so confused now. I have no idea what I want. What do I want, guys? And then it took, like, solid several minutes of those two trying to explain to this guy. And
there's a chronological order.
But you're not a mad person. You're not a mad person. You would just send this guy in a boat somewhere forever.
You send the husband in a boat, I'll send the wife, get rid of
him. Yeah,
wife.
Yeah.
Boom.
There were two of them equally horrible.
What do you mean, first episode?
First episode?
Well, there's the one that was made first, and then there's the one
that's
there were three.
Those don't exist to me.
Okay, there you go.
The one
okay.
that was made
I don't know,
first.
I mean...
I don't, yeah, exactly, A New Hope.
Luke.
I am your
Skywalker.
Father.
Yeah, Luke. Why, like, you didn't pick
Luke
that up? Really?
I was trying to think, is that an actual line, or I thought that was the...
No, he never actually says Luke.
No,
yeah.
He doesn't.
Yeah, wasn't that misquoted?
And in Star Trek,
yes.
They never say,
yeah.
Beam me up, Scotty. And
we
Sherlock
get it, Peter.
Never
You're
says,
not cool.
Elementary, my dear Watson, and I'm quoting that horoscope I got that one time from the mall.
Yeah. We have the best horoscopes
deep,
in all
sexy darkness and deep, sexy brilliance.
I don't remember
are
the
conspiring
to
bring
that
you something
deep
like
the planet, deep, sexy darkness.
This was this guy named Rob something with an S.
Swanson?
Yeah, I think so. Who wrote these?
Swanson.
Yeah, who wrote this horoscope. And it was, yeah, he just stated a bunch of lines.
God damn it.
That's okay, we don't need any more. No mistakes.
Yeah, really, we only have the ones of the prison.
Stay on sunny sides.
It's gonna be a thing now when we make this podcast, I'm gonna make a statement.
I'm glad you got that from, like, the two lines I said. That's incredibly impressive. Kudos to Cleo. To clarify, I just sang very poor rendition of Keep on the Sunny Side from the old brother Where Art Thou soundtrack, and Cleo got that. So kudos, everyone. Not a sarcastic clap. Not a sarcastic clap.
Hey, you.
I know that even... That you're the worst.
What was the phrase you couldn't say, but... So, real. The word real, like, in not in context of saying something is real, but that's real funny, always sounds sarcastic or ridiculously redneck.
That's real funny. Oh, God.
Yeah. That's real fucking funny.
It tastes
real fucking
sardonic.
Funny.
Yeah. Or, you know, you go full redneck with it and...
Hey, it's real fucking funny.
Yeah.
Sure.
What is that strange noise I hear outside my window at night? That would be me.
Real fucking funny.
Yeah.
I'm outside of everybody. I'm like the opposite of Santa in that I visit you every single day, and you never know I come, and I'm always there.
Nice.
So, it's me. Is anyone here with me? I don't know.
No, I don't feel like I, like, see children in the middle of the night.
Not just kids. That's not exclusive. I don't want to be ageist.
I still don't feel like I, visit people.
Do you believe ageism is a thing? Like, is a thing that should be revered and seen as... Or do
no.
you think that, like, the minimum age of respect is probably a little too
yeah.
high?
No.
But do you think that ageism is a thing?
Well, like, ageism is a thing. I don't think it should be, like, a respected thing. Because, yes, there are some pretty young people that have accomplished it, but, like, majority, no. They don't know what the fuck's going on. And so I can't honestly say that someone who's older than someone, like, yes, there will be that rare occasion when the younger person has the know-how to be better than the older person, but it's very rare, and the older person usually knows what they're talking about.
I think that for some reason the younger individual is quicker to jump to conclusions before, even if they have fact-based things to pick up on it.
Yeah.
Like, I feel like it's the same reason why a lot of younger people, I guess, appreciate communism and appreciate, like, certain systems of ideology, that when you add certain components that are logical components, kind of rejects the ideologies, because they don't really consider those components of the ideologies. It ends up with them being like, I wish communism was a thing, or I wish we had an all certain type of person as the leader of government, etc., as opposed to actually taking a second to think about it. I feel like younger people are quicker to jump. I'm not saying younger isn't like a year younger than you or I, or even like 16. I mean, like 13-year-olds and under. But that's what I was saying with the, do you think the minimum age required to gain respect is possibly a little too, on a societal
scale? I don't think,
again,
I don't think it's an age thing. I think it's a more accomplishment thing, because there's totally like 13-year-olds that have accomplished enough that have gained societal respect in whatever field they've chosen
like Malala, for example. Like, you're gonna compare Malala
to youngest Nobel Prize
to like Hillary Clinton.
Yeah, like, because like they've both won a Nobel Prize or whatever, you know, they're on the same level for credentials in a way. So you're like, how can I judge this person based on their age when credentially they're the same as this like 50-year-old or however old X person is? But, you know, in the same regard, there's going to be someone who's that young who's stupid as fuck and is like, carrots are a fruit. And you're going to be like, no, that's not right.
Just right. There's also a ton of stupid adults, just not as
this is true.
Bad.
And because
exactly,
of the internet,
exactly. So it's all kind of individual.
Because of the internet, we've all these stupid facts, all these stupid little factoids that people waste their time with, and it's ridiculous. Is that the second time that's happened?
No.
I watched my little brother when I was little brother. Alright, so this is a new topic. Nat ran into a door. Nat, do you want to tell any stories about you running into a door?
I tried to tempt them.
They're empty.
Okay, no
I ate them all.
The short answer is no.
One time we were in Panama.
You're an incredible asshole.
I'm just kidding.
One time we were in Panama. We were in Mexico at this point, and we were staying at a Hilton in Cancun, and the maid had just come and cleaned the room because we just checked into the room, and we had this view of like all these multiple different swimming pools across the hotel, and my brother got really excited because he liked to swim, so he like ran outside to look at them, and he smacked straight into a glass door because it was so clean that he couldn't tell that there was glass there.
Caden is my favorite. You Caden stories. Let's just tell Caden stories.
Tell Caden stories?
Yeah. I don't have any Caden stories.
I have another Caden story about bugs.
I'm pretty sure he didn't change his shirt for like 3 weeks straight. It was the Joy Division
probably
Unknown Pleasures album cover.
Yeah.
And I'm pretty sure he wore that to English class every day for like 3 weeks.
Probably.
Caden's clean your fucking clothes. You disgust me.
Caden's great though. He's my older brother. He is 19. Greatest guy. Love him to death. But, and he's a lifeguard, and, the summer before last, he was working with, NSLS at Dollar Lake, and it was his first time working at Dollar Lake. He was subbing with them, and, he was there with his guard partner, who was really, really hungover, and she was just kind of rolling around laughing. She was pretty much useless, but he'd taken these paddle boards that they have on one of his breaks and paddled out to the middle of the lake, which was about half an hour to get there. And he's out there and he's just chilling, enjoying the scenery, and then he hears like a zoom go by his head, and it's this bug that is, for reference, the body is about a little bit bigger than in like a bee in totality, and then the stinger is fucking huge. And so he's out there and they just start to swarm around his head and fly everywhere, and he's freaking out and he's like waving his hands to try and get the guard's attention, and he's batting them off with his hand, and there's nothing he can do, so he goes under the water to get away from them because they're swarming his head, and he picks up the paddleboard and starts batting them off in batches with the board. And he's like arms pumping as fast as they can go to try and get to the shore of the lake at this point, which is like half an hour regularly. He ended up getting there in like half the time. And he got to a point and his head was above the water and it like it'd been calm, and he was like, okay. So he got on top of the paddleboard and was like relieved that he'd finally been done with these bugs. So like he runs his fingers through his hair and they're all on top of his head, and they started swarming everywhere.
Oh.
And moral of the story is don't go to Dollar Lake.
He was hallucinating the whole time. he was batting children, small kids, the stingers with their heads. And he bat them up and down across that water.
No.
Is that rye? Did you spill rye?
No.
If so, it's not a big deal, but I'm going to have to like clean that with some soap.
Maybe.
Okay, I'll get some soap on it later.
Can I
get,
grab a handful of this?
Ugh! So Caden speeds children with paddleboards.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Allegedly!
Sure does. Yeah. Nobody's confirmed anything.
Cool, so we've answered, it is me as I am the strange noise. What is the meaning of life? Skip. Do tacos... what is the meaning of life, guys?
Nothing.
I don't think there's a meaning of life.
Pointless.
I think there's...
That is the saddest... I think it's individualistic.
No, yeah,
I think it's fair to say there is no meaning
to life.
No
inherent meaning to life. I think you can give meaning to life.
Yeah. You
That's
choose.
Two. Yeah. I don't think we give meaning to life necessarily. I don't know.
Maybe assign meaning to
we're
life.
Kind
I don't
of,
know what.
Well,
the...
we're given life. Like, off of the bat, we're kind of given life by our
Someone
mom.
Someone forces life upon us.
And our mom and dad. Or if you're a one of those test tube babies,
mm-hmm.
then a test tube gave you life.
That's how it works.
Yeah. what's it called? What's the in vitro?
Yeah.
Yeah, in vitro. In vitro for those. Okay. That's totally rad too, and your science. Your science keeps like you are Frankenstein. But as a whole, I don't think that necessarily we create our own. I don't believe in fate or any of that stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I think my partner put this in a really good way. I think things that have happened were fated to happen because they had happened, and then we are able to like record those things. And so looking back, they had to happen to get in the moment where we are right now. So those certain things, like for example, Cleo, we wouldn't even really know you if you didn't come over to my house in the summer. So that was fated to happen as a result of it already happening. But that is the farthest my belief in any sort of faith goes.
That's like the main theme of The Alchemist, which is an overrated book in my personal opinion, but the main, there's one quote where he's explaining to this girl that he falls in love with why he loves her, and he says, like, I love you because blah, 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 and, like, it's all the steps of the book that happens, and she's like, stop, like, you love somebody because you love somebody. He's like, so I love you because the entire universe has conspired in helping me find you. And, like, the whole, like, pretty much baseline of the book is, like, when you want something, the universe conspires in helping you to get it.
Yeah, what do you guys, that was a bad start. What do you guys think of this whole, like, if you're positive, positive things will happen to you?
Well, I mean, the starving children in Africa really want food, don't they, Peter? And they just wish they had some food. But you know what? Starving children in Africa aren't going to get food, Peter.
I don't know,
they should
I don't
be
know,
more positive.
Yeah, I don't know if that says anything about their attitude. I don't know if they're sitting there like, it's going to happen.
what if that little African child is just so positive? He is just so adamant.
It's the most
that
passive.
One day,
it's the most passive ideology. It's like if you're the universe's bitch.
Yeah.
Like, you're gonna like being the universe's bitch because you're, like, forcing yourself to feel like you should like being the universe's bitch.
Have you seen,
like, no,
or
I'm gonna be the
know the secret?
Yeah.
It's this, like, documentary, pretty much, telling you how all you have to do is, like, want it hard enough.
And it'll happen. And you can make vision boards to help
It's been
you.
18 years wishing for a Holocaust, baby.
Oh, God.
And it hasn't happened yet, baby. I am just kidding.
Well, they open up the thing talking about how, like, all the great leaders since, you know, humans were birthed have used the secret by just wishing really hard for, like, things to go their way, and it works.
That totally demeans all.
Does it work if you do like the Dragon Tales chant? Is that how it works?
I wish I weigh. I wish my might.
No, that's.
Isn't that?
That's
star
like star bright.
Oh yeah.
Oh.
First,
okay, you win this
I
one,
Cleo. I wish I might have the wish I wish tonight.
Ooh, I messed up.
I wish
you're
you
the Dragon Tales.
On a star.
I can't remember.
To carry me. Very funny.
I'm gonna Google it.
If you wish upon a star,
Walt Disney in like the 1920s had all of Walt Disney World figured out up till today. Like way back when was like, this is what's gonna happen.
Mm-hmm.
Well, like to an extent, you know, like that Frozen specifically was.
No.
But
he
like,
knew, like, the park-wise, he knew what was going to happen.
Yeah, like, the layout, the total layout. He also knew that it was going to expand into resorts and stuff like that.
Oh, yeah.
He was an interesting guy. He was also the worst.
Racist, yeah.
What? Okay, but yeah, so being the universe's bitch, not a good thing. What do you guys think of, just real quick, these are all just, like, kind of questions out of the top,
mm-hmm.
but, like, and we'll talk very, I guess, briefly about stories, or not briefly, in fact, here.
Whatever.
Like, this whole thing about Gandhi. Being
beat his wife
and was kind of weird around.
Also?
Yeah. So, what do you think about like? Do you think that first off, do you think that informing the public about this harms the ideology that they try to represent, or do you think it's necessary information to know about them, or do you think alternatively? And then further, it's like, if everybody already knows them, do you think it demeans the character of that individual after this information comes
out? Honest to God, there's a Humans of New York quote that's sticking in my mind about moral absolutionism, where he points out that somebody will, like, bring up, like, an inspirational quote and get you to, like, agree with it and then say that, like, Hitler said it and, like, you know, suggests that a good thought cannot come from a bad person, or, like, point out the fact that, like, Martin Luther King beat his wife and say that, like, just because he's, like, he can't do a bad act because he's a good person, or he is a bad person because that one bad act that he did, when, like, in his time period it was, like, not as bad or more acceptable than it is now.
Yeah, it's like how social justice is injustice.
Yeah.
Which I find really interesting as a prospect. But I showed you the clip of,
yeah.
of the dude talking about,
yeah,
essentially, important sounding adjective used noun.
Yeah.
So, like, social in front of an important noun, like justice, then it's typically for a political ideology, for a political agenda. So, in the case of social justice, it would be for leftist liberal, fucking commie hippie bastards. But for, like, the right wing, I guess it would be, like, Christian justice or something,
mm-hmm.
would obviously be for, like, the right wing,
yeah.
demographic, crazy conservative
the
Christian.
Green Party.
Ban abortion. I want to, like, if you're going to hell, you're going to see your fetus there, right wing, crazy Nazi fascists.
Yeah,
I could go on. So. Like, you have two sides, but in the case of social justice, I find it's very interesting. If you are socially just, you are being unjust. So it's very easy to want to side with, in a case where it's like two guys are in court, it's very easy to side with the poor guy and the rich guy. So if, like, Bill Gates and a homeless hobo bum dude walked into a court together and they had a case against each other, it's very tempting to side with the poor man on just the fact that this poor man
is a poor man,
and that's injustice.
Yeah.
Because it's a contradiction of the justice system. So, I kind of digress from the, just an interesting little
mm-hmm.
side bit. I do agree that, I wasn't, I guess, by my questioning, I wasn't really arguing that a bad action couldn't be done by a good person. I'm saying Should that individual still be held accountable for it after A, accomplishing, for example, freedom for India or major black rights movements and progression? Should that person have to be accountable for it? Or, secondly, should the information be made public? Because if that information is made public, I would argue that it almost demeans the ideology even a little bit.
I still think they should be held accountable, simply because if it demeans the ideology, it gives it almost a human stance point. A human stance point. Because, pardon me, if you're like, well, he had his bad sides, he was incredibly sexist.
There's a bad side isn't like, that guy had a lot of cake, and that guy beat his wife a whole bunch. Like,
well, yeah, and I feel like you should be held accountably so for that.
I think we should live in a world where it's inhumane to beat your wife. Therefore,
yeah,
you don't
yeah,
give
yeah.
someone a human characteristic that is inhumane.
Yeah.
So, I would argue if you want to keep and preserve an ideology that is relatable, you definitely don't want to make that ideology leader someone who beats their wife and is super rapey around, trigger warning, rapey around their, like, nieces or nephews or cousins. So, I don't know, Obviously, I mean, I like information, and especially on a political level, information to the public. I do. I just don't think that it is A, necessary, or B, beneficial towards a movement, especially one of race.
Yeah. Proud.
But I am the dictator, apparently. I don't know, what do you guys feel like?
You probably agree with Hitler.
You know, I'm pretty much the next Hitler. I'm a Nazi.
Yeah.
You're
a skinhead.
Straight cis male.
so, like, how can you not be Hitler?
One more question. Do tacos gent? No.
Pardon?
Tacos gent. It's a way of playing music that's almost... We went over this before in a previous podcast. No, they do not gent. Tacos do not gent. Stop.
Tacos don't gent?
Stop. All right.
Stop it.
All out of 10.
We're all out of questions?
All out of questions.
Well, stories, anyone?
Yeah. You don't have any stories? It's summer now. Any summer-related... Not ski! But, summer-related... Not ski because of the snow or whatever. Summer-related stories... No one has summer-related stories. I got to pet ducks. I got to pet ducklings. I got to pet them. I got to almost kiss one, and then I realized it'd be gross and unsanitary.
You should have kissed one.
Yeah.
I should have kissed one.
People kiss cod.
You missed
all the time.
An opportunity.
Cod.
Yeah,
catch a cod.
You drink. You drink. You know, moose piss out of a boo. You kiss a cod. You're a Newfoundlander.
Yeah,
okay. Why do they optionally?
It's not optional.
Anyway, you didn't kiss the duck. You can't speak.
You should have kissed the duck.
I still want to hear the story.
You should have. That's what we're telling you.
Yeah.
Well, I was really excited. Mackenzie and I put $2 worth of duck food into my hands, and they nibbled at it with their little duck beaks, and it was so cute. One duck had a squashed beak, though.
Aww.
And I felt bad, and I wanted to take it home. Also, I only got a pet duck, and PETA advises me not to, so I'm definitely going to now, because PETA is the worst organization.
Yep.
They euthanize, like, 94% of the dogs they rescue and the cats they rescue. That's like thousands of dogs and cats every year.
Yeah.
Because they're like, better save you from these awful owners to kill you.
I better just kill you now.
I'd much rather be beaten by my parents than killed by, like, the social services program. Do you think that's what they do? Do you think by, like, slipping through the cracks they mean killing?
We're gonna let your animals slip through the cracks and get to a better place.
Slip through butt cracks. Because they're the shit of society. They're the butt of every joke.
Oh, yeah. That's a good one.
You're the butt of life.
Oh,
okay.
No.
So you guys don't have any stories?
No.
That was alright.
Well, we have the van in New Brunswick.
Oh.
James Faye knows
because he slapped somebody.
Alright, well, he slapped somebody.
Just know, you're not gonna know why
But James Face slapped him.
No, I slapped someone.
Hard?
He was a friend.
Pretty solid.
Yeah.
Was it a KO?
Let's say it was a knockout.
I think it was a knockout.
They flew a little?
A little. Quote unquote a little. A lot. that's what I'm saying.
It worked. That's all you need to know.
And Cleo, you moved out recently. Any moving out stories? No, like you moved out of your mom's house. Like you moved houses.
Don't even have any interesting moving stories from like the 8 times we've moved.
How has the photo wall been going? Have you put a photo wall up?
There's like 3 photos up as of right now because of testing a green tape that is supposed to be safe on paint to humor my mother, even though Scotch tape worked perfectly fine before. But as of right now, all 3 of you are on the wall, actually. James was the first one up, and then the second picture is the only picture I have with Nat, and one of the only ones I have with you, which is New Year's Eve. yeah.
I want to look like a dog.
And then
like
it's
a Labrador.
Me, Aaron, and Robin, and then it's a picture of Rainbow Haven Beach, I think.
Nice.
That's all for right now.
Yeah, we, like, I don't have a lot of pictures.
No, we've said, like, multiple times. We need to get a picture. But,
and then we do that, and then
we don't get a picture.
I always do funny faces in photos.
You do that thing.
Your normal face is funny. Well, you're right, but that's not the question here, Peter.
You do that thing where, like, you retract into your neck.
I can't really do that anymore.
Like, it's just,
beard?
Beard?
It just extends. My beard
this
looks
has been
larger.
2 weeks. It's going to be gone in the morning. Everyone should appreciate it now.
This has been many months.
Ugh.
It's been many months. But, like, I don't know. Should I...
People can't see the beards. Just...
Yeah. I just do that. This is an audio-based medium, and we're using, like,
picture a long beard.
Picture Gandalf. That's
then,
how long my beard is.
And then picture, like, a baby.
That's how long my pubes are. Newly born and Gandalf hitting puberty.
Would you rather penis-sized pubes or
keep going.
Or a pube-sized penis?
Penis-sized pubes?
Yeah, can you just...
At least then I don't have a penis-sized pube.
And are you not capable of shaving, or...?
You are, but I can't imagine that wouldn't break your razor. That's an Oreo small dick.
What?
Because it's a big chunk of hair, or if it's a small... I don't know.
Fire.
And it grows very fast. It's just thick. It's just like your pores.
Oh, God.
Cleo, you're ridiculous.
Sorry. Stop kicking knives.
Okay.
Do you
want
a
background
just,
on the
just, I'm not going to eat that. It's
what's the question I asked earlier? Wait, would you rather have... What was it? The eyeball. Would you rather have... Yeah.
What is it? Anuses for eyes or an eyeball for an anus?
I don't think it was anuses for eyes, because I don't think it was that. I don't think it was that bad.
I think it was that bad.
That'd be terrifying.
I think it was, would you rather have an anus for an eyeball or...
I thought it was... Anuses for eyes, too. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's what you said.
That's a logical
swap. That's pretty
like,
weird.
But
you
just now realizing the things that come
out
of your mouth.
An eye and your anus. Both are pretty...
Yeah, would you rather have an eyeball for an anus or an anus for a nose? Or for a mouth?
For a mouth?
You can taste it?
Would you be spitting out shit?
Or
would you be constantly just shitting out, like, more shit?
Okay, wait, so the first option...
No, because you get like, oh, do you think that deaf people realize that farts make sounds?
I hope someone tells them. You can feel farts sometimes,
do you think
right?
They just like think it's like flexing their asshole? they I don't know, do you think it makes sound? To them?
I feel like
at one point someone would tell them?
Oh no, like television shows with the little audio readings at the... At the bottom,
fart
you know, with the subtitles
or I never really watched a whole lot of television.
Okay,
shows
but they have sound cues and brackets.
This show is brought to you with Describe Video for the visually impaired.
Yeah, and then the bottom
that's
it'll
not,
be like
that's
laughs
not the
and
right
Asian
one though. That's for the visually impaired. The subtitles. Yeah.
Oh yeah, no.
For the visual. Well, there's Describe Video for the visually impaired. We're talking about the deaf people.
Deaf people.
Are we?
Yeah, I just don't know why I brought that up.
Okay.
Cool. You got me there.
But yeah, do you think that they hear their own farts? Do you think that, like, that they have any awkward farts?
Again,
farts?
I hope they figure it out.
No, the first time I farted.
Wait, no, I actually remembered why I brought that up, and it was not for the visually impaired. I'm talking about just plain old subtitles.
Oh, okay, yeah.
But it has, like, sound cues in it.
Oh, yeah.
And it'll be, like, laughs and
singing
foreign
or,
language
yeah.
or something like that.
Fact
I'm sure it says fart
like,
at some point.
Like,
just, like, in brackets.
Crazy Jew chuckling. Like, oh, yeah, 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 yeah. Oh, God, I'm sorry.
Yeah,
on the real,
it
I
said, like,
the
crazy
Jews.
Chuckling at first, and you're like, this scene doesn't make sense. And
I love the
Jews.
I sold them. I sold them. Like,
end of sentence.
Foreskin.
How well do you think he get along with Spencer?
Very
Spencer.
Well.
Oh,
Spencer
like,
Dory?
12.
Yeah.
12. How much swag you got? 14.
I know what he meant.
Yeah, 12 out of 10.
Yeah.
I love the Jews. I just sold them.
He also loves
the Jews.
I just
found
out what a brisk was for just the other day.
Really, what's that?
It's like a foreskin party. It's like the yanking of the foreskin. It's everyone. It's like a, okay, imagine like a, you know, like, you know, like at a wedding, the couple, like, like they hold hands cutting the cake. It's like that at a brisk where everyone gets together and holds one knife and just, like, cuts the foreskin off. Like a sword. Like, they hold their Jewish sword. They
I
go,
wish
stop, stop doing that motion while you're cutting off a foreskin so close to me.
Lightsaber, like,
sorry, can you feel it, right?
Wow. The
Boom Shakalaka has a...
Here comes the Chief Rocka.
My best friend and I, Sydney Gunnar and I, we... had a late night conversation. She had called me on the phone. It was 3 o'clock in the morning, and which is almost 3 o'clock in the morning now. So we're probably gonna head to bed soon. But can I tell a story quick? Yeah, she was like,
yeah.
Like, dude, where do they even? I think actually, no matter. Oh no, it was Sydney. Like, where does the foreskin even go after they do that? Like, is it just in like the trash, or do they have a special place for the foreskin? Is there like a foreskin factory where they like ship it to like kids in China or something and like label it as like American, like potatoes or something? Like,
onion rings.
Like, like George Bush Jr. has a really sick taste in humor, and he sent it to her, like to the Hurricane Katrina survivors as a care package, and then that's when Kanye West found out, and he's like, George Bush does not care about black people. Is that where that came from?
Probably.
Yeah, that's where it came from.
That's an elaborate joke that just fell
it
so flat. Nobody laughed.
Long walk for a short drink of water.
Oh,
home twerk, settle down. Settle down, home twerk. Anyway. Well, it's getting late.
It's getting pretty late, Peter.
I think we have to wrap things up.
I think we gotta check out who's got the bill.
I don't know how I segue into
that's a pretty good segue.
Been a couple of quackers.
I do not know who got the bill.
Really?
Who got the bill, Nathaniel?
I don't know, Peter. Why don't you tell me who got the bill, Peter?
I'm not used to reading scripts. I do not know, Nathaniel.
Peter, tell me who's got the bill.
Don't worry.
We've got the bill.
I didn't have it ready. Why are you doing that?
I gave you like a solid 5 seconds to like get that ready. Everyone on the count of three. One, two, three.
We've got the bill. Got it. Oh.